I'm here with Jose Maria Alvarez, my dear friend, who's the CEO of Telefonica. Thank you for being here, Jose Maria.
My pleasure.
So I first wanted to start maybe with the work we're doing together and some place where you're innovating, which is AI. You built Aura. Maybe you want to talk a little bit about how what AI means and cognitive services mean for the future of Telefonica's innovation.
For sure. We are very excited. You know, we used to be a voice factory, but the voice network is not coping anymore to produce the amount of data that our customer needs. And therefore, we are basically building a brand new factory based on fiber, 4G, and prepared for 5G. That means a huge change in everything, top down, bottom up, network systems, products and services. So while we are doing that, which is our, the core of our business, we have realized that artificial intelligence brings a brand new opportunity. So integrating artificial intelligence in a telecom network is a brand new field. And in that regard, the sky's the limit. There are endless possibilities. And working with Microsoft is helping us a lot to understand all the real power of artificial intelligence.
That's fantastic. The other thing that you've taken a stance all through is being around trust. It's at the core. In fact, you've even declared the principles of trust around AI. Maybe you want to talk about both why is it so important to you and to your customers, as well as how do you balance it with innovation?
Sure. I mean, as a communication company, as a telecommunication company, trust is essential. The core of our values needs to be trust. Our customers deposit the trust on that while they talk to each other, while they communicate with each other, and therefore the integrity of our service needs to be protected. So trust, security, privacy are essential values. Our history, and especially relevant in this brand new world of data. So building trust in every single component of this brand new product, which is data and all its derivatives, is essential. We have decided that rules are not written in that space, namely on the artificial intelligence arena. So we have established three basic principles, which is Renato said it's secure, the customer needs to feel that it's secure, that is integral, and that he's empowered, he's in command of what's going on. And that applies not just to traditional communication, but also to the artificial intelligence layer. Right. And therefore, we need to set what are the basic principles that we are going to be applying when introducing artificial intelligence into a telecommunication operator.
That's fantastic. Running a telecommunications company, especially at a time like this, here we are at Mobile World Congress, everybody's talking about 5G, edge computing, there's blockchain, there's a lot of technologies. What do you think is the future of a telecommunications company, and more particularly Telefonica?
I think that we should not forget what is the main reason why a customer comes to us, which is connectivity. And therefore, having a state-of-the-art connectivity, and that means fiber, that means 4G, and being prepared for 5G is essential. This is the cornerstone. But the more we deploy this brand new network, the more capabilities we discover on our own, even on our own core product. And therefore, radically changing our systems, having all the information that the network is able to generate in real time, is essential. And if you have those two layers, your network and your systems in good shape, plugging in technology is very efficient. We become a massive distributor of technology. And that means blockchain, artificial intelligence, virtual or augmented reality, in the future robotics. It's very easy. If you have APIs, if you have a network that is API enabled, it's relatively easy. So we see our networks in the future being radically different from the past. Highly cognitive networks and prepare to be a technology enabler. I mean, that's what we think our mission is.
Talking about mission, one of the things that's really inspiring for me is to meet leaders who have a crisp sense of purpose and mission that directs everything that you're doing. In fact, the mission you talk about is to make our world more human by connecting lives. Maybe you want to talk a little bit about your leadership philosophy that sort of really helps drive Telefonica and the people who work there forward with the sense of purpose and pride.
Certainly. We are a 94-year-old company, and our history is essential to understand what we believe in. We believe in bringing technology to people. But we think technology is essential, but the most essential part is people. So we think that we need to make sure that this huge revolution that we are living, this massive access to technology, we don't forget that technology is to serve people and not the other way around. So we think that it needs to be human-centric. It needs to be social-centric. Technology is going to be able to do a lot of things. Are all of them acceptable as a society? What are the values that we need to have? And we think we need to start by ourselves. So our role is to try to make our world more human by bringing communication to people.
That's right. It's never about technology for its own sake, but it's the impact it has on people and society.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for being here, Jose Maria.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.